Hi, this is chapter 9, lesson 5. We're talking about how can I use operations to model real-world fractions. And we're doing a problem-solving investigation today. So please read through. It takes you step by step on both this example and the example on the next page. Remember here you pull out what pieces of information you need from the problem. You just basically restate the question, and then what operation you're going to use and what strategies you're going to use to solve, and then show your work here, and then explain why your answer makes sense. I'm going to show you how to do it when they only give you this much workspace. So here we've got Chloe did some of her school homework before dinner. She did 2/6 of her homework after dinner. She has 1/6 of her homework left. What fraction of her homework did Chloe do before her dinner? Write in simplest form. We're not going to worry about the simplest form part. Okay, so one piece of information I need is she did 2/6 of her homework after dinner. She has 1/6 of her homework left. And we need to find out what she did before her dinner. So that's going to be a key to help me figure out my problem. And since I have how much she did after and I have what was left, that's going to tell me that's my answer, basically my answer. 1/6 is what she has left to do. She did 2/6 of it after dinner. And what we need to figure out is how much she did before dinner. And since we're solving or like fractions, we know our denominator is going to be 6. So what are we going to do to figure out if we have this total amount, we're taking away 2/6, and then we're left with 1/6. So what amount has to be here? That's the question. And because it's basically telling us what she had left over, I can tell that this is going to be a subtraction equation. You might want to say 6/6 is what she started with because that would be the whole amount of homework. But if you had 6/6 minus 2/6, would you end up with 1/6 left over? No, that wouldn't work. So how much is it to make this equation true? That would be your fraction for what she did before dinner, even though it doesn't make a whole. That's how you solve that one. There were 12 goals scored during the game. Team A scored 8/12 of the goals. Team B scored 2 goals during the first half of the game. What fraction of the goals did Team B score during the second half of the game? Write in simplest form. And again, we're not going to worry about simplest form. Okay, so you're starting out in this one, you are starting out with 12 twelfths because it tells you there are 12 goals scored. Team A scored 8 twelfths. And it doesn't tell you, but you can figure that one out. Okay, and then Team B scored 2 goals, so that's going to be 2 out of 12. And then you're going to get what fraction of the goals did Team B score during the second half? Does that make sense? So you're taking this answer and you're doing a second operation with it, with the 2 goals that they scored in the first half to figure out the second half. And then you're going to write your sentence here. The question is, what fraction of the goals did Team B score during the second half? So you'd say Team B scored the answer goals during the second half of the game. And remember, you're writing it as a fraction. And since we're talking about like fractions, I know my denominator is going to be 12. Okay. Brandy and her mom are at a pet store. The pet store has 12 reptiles. Of the reptiles, 5 are turtles, 2/12 are snakes, and the rest are lizards. So, what fraction of the reptiles is lizards? So, this is a two-step problem. It's just like number two. So, you should be able to set that up. And remember, you're starting out with the whole, which is 12/12. And then you're doing your same operation. You're doing it twice with the numbers that they've given you in the problem. And then you're writing your sentence. The number of reptiles that are lizards is the fraction. Okay? So that's how you get started with this work. And when you get to the next page, 4 and 5 are just like the two that you've done before. So it's the double step problem with the same operation. Number 6 does not require fractions. So that's just a problem solving one for you to work through. So read that carefully and know that you don't necessarily have to do fractions in order to get the answer. Now, number 7 is not really a fraction problem either. It's basically just asking you what operation is happening here. So, if you have 8 costumes, what are you doing to end up with 24? So, what's happening to 9 in order to get 27? And whatever is happening needs to be the same pattern all the way through. So, you can't do one operation here and a different operation there and a different operation there and a different operation there. They would need to be the same pattern. So you need to figure out what that pattern is. If you were having a little math machine and you put in 8 and it spit out 24, what is the machine doing? Is basically what you're trying to figure out. And then you can continue the table and figure out the answer to this question and then write your complete sentence answer down here. So that's how these ones are done. Please remember to use your workspace to show your work and your lines to write your complete sentence answers. And if this takes you 20 minutes to finish, then you're done. If you have not used your full 20 minutes, then do please practice through the homework problems. And that will help you develop your skills so that you've got this solid in time for the test. Thanks so much.